Dr. Laura is on right now.
Hayden and Callie, welcome to the program.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Dr. Laura.
Hi. Who are you to each other?
We are husband and wife.
Got it.
We've been married for almost 6 years.
And how old is everybody?
I'm 26 and my husband's 27.
And I heard a little voice in the background. How many kids? How old?
We have one baby boy and he's 4 months old.
Oh my gosh. He's just a dittos.
Yes.
Oh. All right. Now I wish you were here and I could hold the baby while we were having this conversation, but I can't.
So let's
move on. What's happening?
Okay. So I have four sisters and about a year and a half ago, one of my older sisters went to my mom's house and told my mom that she's getting married to this boyfriend that we all don't like, and then stormed out and told my mom that we're all dead to her and she doesn't want anything to do with us anymore.
Okay, excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me. Trouble with her started 20 years before that day. Now, you weren't alive for all of that. That was not out of the clear of blue. The reason she was with a, quote, you all didn't like him, he must, either you're all strange or he was not the best guy. The reason she picked somebody like that is that's her equal. So when he wasn't accepted, that doubled down that she wasn't accepted, and she's mad. She's had problems from day one. Ask your mother.
Yeah, so why she thinks we're judging her is because she
deserves judgment. She deserves judgment. We all do. We all do. You judge listening to me. You judge each other's behavior here. And you judge whether the kid is doing what we make judgments all the time. That's how we learn about things. Now, there's a difference between being inappropriately judged negatively, like a bias, but making judgments, you have to make them. Is this a healthy thing? Is this not a healthy thing? Is this a righteous thing? Is this not a righteous thing? Judging happens all the time. All I'm saying is that my best guess would be she's always been a difficult child in the family.
Yeah.
And she found somebody
to
tolerate her. Leave her alone. Let her have her life.
Okay, so how do we go? Because half of my family wants to reach out.
Let everybody do whatever they want to do. You're married to a nice man. You have a new baby. Please, Hayden, tell her not to get invested in this insanity. Please. You shouldn't be bringing it home to Hayden and your baby.
I'm on the page where I don't want to reach out, but some of my family's like,
let them do whatever they want to do. You make your choice. They make their choice. Mothers in particular don't like to let go, no matter what. He could have murdered 16 people. She could have murdered 16 people, and she'd still want to reach out. Moms tend to be like that. Let them all do what their guilt and need and fears let them do. You do what you want to do. And if anybody asks you about that, you say, you know, I respect her decision. I got a husband. I got a kid. I'm busy.
Yeah.
That's it. Don't let them drag you into the drama. Please. I freaked out when you said how many sisters you had. If you had 16 brothers, we probably wouldn't be on the phone.
Yeah, probably not.
Right. Let her be. And let everybody else do what the hell they want. And don't bring this into your home.
Okay, that sounds good.
Excellent. I'm sorry, Hayden. Did you have anything to say today?
I do not. It's been, I think we're on the same page. All three of us are.
Good.
Just, you know, the family puts a lot of pressure on everybody else. And I've said the same thing as let them do what they want. If they want to accept her back, or if she wants to come back and they want to be friendly, that's great. But we have to make our own decisions.
Yes.
For our own family.
And Hayden just remind Callie that if she's challenged by anybody, including her mother, to say, Mom, your decisions are yours. Mine are mine. I got a husband and a kid and a parakeet. I don't know if you have a parakeet. And I'm kind of busy. I do what you want. If they have a big event and you go and she's there, just be polite like you would be to anybody else in the room.
Yep.
Sounds good.
Okay. I'm sorry, Callie, were you going to ask something or say something?
No, I don't know.
Yes, you were. Yes, you were.
I was making sure he's not rolling off the bed.
Oh, okay.
We were thinking, Callie was also thinking, Dr. Laura, that, you know, some of the family that interacts with her, she claims, you know, I do want a relationship with my sisters in the future. And so Callie was, we were contemplating last night, is she wanted to write a letter and just say, hey, you know, we're, you go live your life. That's great.
No,
we're kind of,
no,
okay,
nothing in writing. That's engaging. Don't engage any of this. Just be a polite bystander. Make believe you're not the member of the family. I doubt that's going to happen. If she does,
I doubt it,
then just be polite. Don't engage. You have a life with Hayden and your baby. Don't go backwards.
Yeah.
Don't go backwards.
Yep. We got a very busy baby now, so.
That's right. Okay.
Very good.
You good, Callie?
Yep.
Good. Excellent. Thank you both for calling. My number, 1-800-375-2872. It's not a matter of doing anything vengeful. It's just a matter of letting that go down the river. Just let it go down the river while you stay on the land doing your thing.